I'm Michelle Gayle, and I'm the writer of Pride and Premiership. The book is about a girl called Remy, who's 17 and a half, very important, and she has goals. One goal is to open her own salon, the other is to marry a Premiership footballer. And throughout the book, we get to see her try to achieve both goals. And I'm going to read you a short extract from the book. Sunday, 22nd of June, 2:30 a.m. OMG. I've just logged a Premiership footballer. His name is Robbie Wilkins and he plays for Neverfield Park Rangers. Okay, it's not a massive club like Man United or Chelsea, which Gary, well, Malibu Golf happens to pay for. But Robbie's still a good catch. Malibu says the players at smaller clubs get about £20,000 a week. 20 grand! That's more than I make in a year manicuring and waxing people at Cara's. Robbie is 21 and blonde with highlights. Highlights will have to go. But apart from his hair and slightly big nose, he's buff beyond belief. He's proper charming too. He told me that I looked like a young Julia Roberts. Although, to be honest, I don't think you would have noticed me if it hadn't been for Malibu's plan. That girl is so clued up. She went to the lounge 4 times just to do her research and has seen 6 different Premiership players there. Apparently, they usually sit in a VIP area in the back of the club, and within seconds they're surrounded by girls who act like lap dancers in front of them, or reach over to pass them their phone number. If they get lucky, some girls even leave with a player or two, said Malibu. But we're not aiming for that. Huh? I went, confused. No, she said firmly. The same players come back the next week, blank the girls that were all over them last time, and move on to a fresh set. We're real wag material, Remy, not bloody wannabes. You're right, I thought. I mean, Malibu is wag material all day long. Blonde, skinny, big boobs, lucky cow. But me, I didn't think I'd stand a chance. But my genius sister had it all worked out. Her carefully calculated strategy was for us to separate ourselves from the wag wannabes as soon as we got there. They're so easy, she says, and boys, especially footballers, are all about the chase. See what I mean about being clued up? When we arrived, there's a massive line of people waiting to get in. And when we finally got up to the door, the bouncer double-triple-checked my fake ID. I thought he was going to turn me away, so I threw him a massive smile and made my eyes say, please. Go on then, he said, sucker. The lounge is like nowhere I've ever been before. Everything about it says money. It also happened to be full of good-looking girls aiming to call themselves a footballer. And with me in my white jeans and Primani sparkly top, and Malibu in her denim jumpsuit, we looked like we were going skiing compared to what those wag wannabes had on. They were half bloody naked. The boys there weren't exactly shy either. I got my first chat-up line within 10 minutes. Get your coat. We're going home, he said. We're not interested, Malibu snapped. Before I could say a word. The wag wannabes weren't interested either. They were turning boys away big time, waiting for the real deal. And then, Robbie and Gary stepped through the door. I knew they were footballers straight away. I'd like to say it was because I'd done my research, like Malibu, or that it was because they were dressed immaculately, which they were, and walked with a swagger, which they did. But to be honest, the only reason I knew they were footballers was because those wag wannabes swarmed round them like bees to a jar of honey. Robbie and Gary fought their way through the heaving breasts and plumped themselves down in the VIP area. Then Malibu looked at me, gave me a wink, and we strutted straight past them without, and this was important, even glancing their way and hit the dance floor. This worked out perfectly for me, because Malibu made me the blonde, prettier and skinnier one with those boobs, of course, which just isn't fair, but she can't dance to save her life. When Crazy in Love started, she looked like she was having a fit, while I did the dance that Beyonce does in the video. Oh, 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 oh. And let some Robbie tap my shoulder and ask me to go outside with him for some fresh air. We talked about the usual at first. What's your name, age, etc. And when I told him it was my half birthday tomorrow, he said it was a cool thing to celebrate. Thanks, I replied. Pleasure, he said. Then he threw me a look that made my stomach do a double somersault. I knew what was coming next and couldn't wait, but also remember what Malibu said about how if a girl holds out, a footballer will want her more because they love to win. So, gutted.
told him I was only up for kissing. That's new, he replied. And then we got stuck in. His kisses were a bit sloppy, to be honest. But I put that down to him having a few drinks. Anyway, who cares? When our lips unlocked, he asked my number and said he's dying to see me again. Just like Malibu predicted. She did a right number on Gary too. When Robbie walked me back inside, we couldn't find him for ages. So I decided to check whether she was in the loo and spotted her and Gary propped up against the wall beside a fire exit, snogging. Your sister, Gary said when he realised I was gawping at them, is the most stunning girl I've ever met. Malibu's proper. She says it's a big sister's job to educate, and she's put all her years of reading every WAG interview ever given to good use by making the WAG charter. It's a 5-point plan that Malibu reckons will get us a footballer quicker than we can save Frank Lampard. And it seems to be working. Yay! I'm going to write it down so that in weak moments I can look at it and think of the big picture. Because I'd love to marry Robbie, so I can jack in my job and shop for the rest of my life. The WAG charter. 1. To start with, pretend you don't know he's a footballer. 2. Stick to kissing on the first date. 3. Don't let him see you drunk, or he won't trust you when he's away on a pre-season tour. 4. Wait 8 weeks to hit fourth base. Footballers marry good girls they can bring home to their mums. 5. Never dispute a thing his mum says. They worship their mums.